everyone hates unresponsive, low FPS games. If only there was a way to fix that. Oh, interesting. I think we all know the benefits of having higher FPS. Higher FPS results in a much smoother experience. But what about input lag? Input lag, in short, is the amount of time it takes between you sending an input through either your keyboard or mouse and that action to be displayed on your screen. As an example of how bad it can get, if we were to take a game that runs at exactly 60 FPS on a 60Hz monitor, the minimum theoretical input lag for the overall system is about 16ms. You get this number when you divide 1 frame by 60. At 30 FPS it's even worse, at 33ms. Basically for multiplayer games, everything that's being displayed to you is delayed compared to what's actually happening inside the game. The delay numbers I gave you are actually your best scenario, that's the minimum theoretical input lag. Besides display lag, there can be mouse input lag for example, there can be also system related input lag. The simplest and least technical way is to just get a high refresh rate monitor and a really good PC. But what if we can't do that? Maybe we can't afford this. And even if we do, sometimes even with high FPS and high refresh rate, the game still feels sluggish. Besides hardware itself, there have been a ton of solutions that claim to fix input lag, such as ultra low latency modes and other recent developments like Nvidia Reflex for example. But even without this stuff, there are plenty of Windows settings that will still help you a bunch without needing any specific hardware piece, and many of these also improve your FPS. Note, if your system already has low input lag, like the guys I've tested this with, there won't be much of a difference when it comes to input lag, but your FPS should still improve. Let's start with game mode and game bar. These are the two settings that had the biggest impact on my game's performance and we'll talk about each. Simply type game mode settings in your Windows search bar and open it. Game mode is good if you have a very low-end system. However, if you have a mid-end system or high-end system, it's better to turn this off because it actually hurts your frame rate. In theory, the PC should prioritize games over everything else, but it just doesn't seem to work, so turn it off and see how it goes. Xbox game bar, however, is something you always want to turn it off. Its only purpose is to capture footage and there is much better software out there that does the same thing without the performance hit that these settings alone has. Make sure your power settings are set up correctly. Under control panel, hardware and sound, power options, make sure you're set on high performance. If you're using a laptop, this will consume more of your battery, but you'll have much higher FPS. It also helps PC performance a lot, but this will draw a bit more power, but you can shrug that one off. This next setting will actually improve two things, your FPS and your mouse movements in game. If you had issues with your mouse movements, it's time to fix that right now. First you wanna go into Valorant's install folder. This works for any game by the way, so if you play other games, feel free to do it to them as well. If you haven't changed the default install location of the game, it will be located under C, Red Games, Valorant, Live, Shooter Game, Binaries, Win64. You want to select the Valorant Win64 shipping executable, then right-click it and select Properties. After that, go to Compatibility and do the following. Enable Run as Administrator. Enable Display Full Screen Optimizations. Quick note for this setting, if you use overlays they may not work anymore, and alt-tabbing will be slower. But you do get a significant FPS boost out of this. After checking those two settings, click Change High DPI Settings and enable Override High DPI Scaling Behavior Scaling Performed By and make sure that it's set to Application. This is the setting that will fix your mouse smoothness. Add Valorant and write Vanguard to Threat Exclusions. Type in Virus in Windows Search and open Virus and Threat Protection. Under Virus and Threat Protection settings, click Manage Settings, scroll down to Exclusions and then click Add an Exclusion. Select folder and then add Riot Games folder, default under C/Riot Games, and after you've done that you want to add Riot Vanguard as well, default under C, Program Files, Riot Vanguard. The last setting that doesn't require you to have any specific hardware is to set the game priority to above normal or high. Simply run the game, go under Details and select the Win64 shipping process. Right click it and select priority to above normal or high. Do not touch real time as this can mess up your PC. This setting may only be beneficial for lower end PCs, I don't see much of a difference myself, but it's worth trying out to see if it does for you. Time for some Nvidia specific settings. In the Nvidia control panel, you can technically just copy what you see on the screen, but the settings you care most about are the following. Power management. Set this one to prefer maximum performance. And low latency mode. If your GPU is good, turn this one to off. If your GPU is bad, turn this one to on. If you have a GTX 1060 or higher, you can turn this off. Next up, if you run the game in your native desktop resolution, go under Adjust Desktop Size and Positions, and under Scaling, select No Scaling. This next setting might seem like a Windows setting, but it's actually Nvidia specific. You need to have Windows 2004 or higher, and you also need a GTX 10 card or higher. The setting is called Hardware Accelerated GPU Scheduling, a fancy word for higher FPS if you have a good GPU, and to find this setting simply go to your desktop, right click it, open display settings, scroll down to graphics settings and turn it on. Reminder that you need to restart your PC for this setting to take effect. Now we're gonna talk about Nvidia Reflex. You need an Nvidia GTX 10 card or higher, or this option will not be available for you. You can find it inside of Valorant under Video, always have this setting on. The question is whether or not you should have the boost on as well or not. Thankfully, the answer is simple. If you already have high FPS, turn boost on. If you don't, turn it off. The setting will have a slight impact on your FPS, but if you can afford the FPS hit, turn it on. Team Red, I'm sorry, I can't go into too much detail because I don't own an AMD card, but thankfully I have an immortal friend that happens to own one and I've asked him what are the settings he's using and he shared this screenshot with me. You can see the stats on screen, which I find really useful, low input lag, high FPS, apply them and see how it goes. One thing to note is that you may want to experiment with Radeon anti-lag. If your GPU bottlenecks you, then it's better to turn it on, but if your GPU is good, like a 15700 XT, then you probably want to turn it off. After you apply all of these settings, Windows, Nvidia, AMD, depending on which card you have, should make your game a lot more smoother and should definitely unlock your potential a little further. Thank you for watching, have a wonderful day.